So hi, I'm Veronica, and we are back painting using our techniques of Frisket, and we're talking a lot about value today. So here is my photograph I'm using, and it's very complicated. But what we're going to try to do is talk about how to create a painting and create something that has good composition. We're going to be looking at this piece in terms of shape. And what I have everybody do is create a thumbnail sketch of this image. So we're reducing things to shapes. So it's not so complicated like this. We're down to shapes. And we're talking a lot about how to change out some of the trees so they're different. That these two trees here are the same shape. We want difference. We want that stream to create this S curve, which is a really wonderful composition to use for painting. So I've created this as a value sketch. So I now know that my trees are dark. I'm gonna have darkness in here and along the side of the stream. Granted, it's gonna not be a perfect line on the stream. It's gonna be rocks that are going to lead our eye up into this little area where the light is coming. The light is coming across from about right here. So the other thing we wanna do is we wanna apply Frisket so that we can retain the white of our paper. So the sun is coming across. It's illuminating the leaves down in here. On this side of the trunks, we're gonna have that white. We're not gonna have to worry too much about that light because now it's protected. When we're all done with that painting behind and the trunk, then we can come back in and take the Frisket off. So thanks for joining me today. Okay, so we've got on our mixing tray the atmospheric colors. They are the primary colors. We have a cadmium yellow, alizarin crimson, and a cobalt blue. We're gonna utilize those colors. We'll be adding more colors, of course, because how can we resist? But we're wanting to think about the light.
Repeat your colors.
Cadmium yellow, alizarin crimson, and cobalt blue. All right, use the biggest brush you can. So I love this handy little brush right here, about 3 inch. It's well loved. You can see the paint's off of here because I left it in the water too long. So that's not what you want to do.
If you wouldn't put it in the water, you wouldn't have that problem.
I know. So here's my piece. Now, you gotta remember, where's the light? Where have we decided the value of light is? It's gonna be down in the stream. And it's gonna be up in here. So do not be painting in those areas. Leave it dry if you can. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna paint in here water. I'm painting with water. I'm gonna go fast and furious because I got this big lovely brush. I know that in here it's gonna be dark. It's gonna be light in here. We're painting a little differently today. We're gonna be painting large shapes, doing the same thing when we lay down the first bits of color. Okay, I'm gonna start with the lightest color. My sun's over here. I know my sun's over here. Just like that. I kind of have to tip it a little bit down. Then I go into my reds. Like this.
Where do you see that red? You should see all those colors. Use your imagination.
I'm using my artist brain.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. That's a scary thing, my artist brain. Okay. It's going to really be nice. It's going to help ground your piece and allow your eye and your brain to see. The viewer's going to see where's the light coming from. We'll be painting over the top with greens. I'm leaving this light, okay? And where are my dark values? There's dark values over here. I'm gonna get a little bit of that dark value in there, because I know that's there. Where else do we have dark value. Well, I know that the trees are dark, but we're going to have to wait to paint that. I'll just come in here just to kind of get the essence of where the light is. Where's that light? So, do you see how it's an emotion right now? You created, the colors are blending together, and the only reason they're blending together is because we painted with water first. It's the number one problem when people do this kind of painting is not to paint with water. Paint with water, and then you can create this. And I'm going to clean this brush really good. And I see some areas that I want to lift up a little bit, smooth out, because I have hard edges. I don't want hard edges. So I have some yellows right in here too, where the light is coming through, right? A little bit of light. But I'm careful to leave some white in there. It goes yellow, red, blue. And it's important you do it in that order because if you put blue next to yellow, what color do you get?
Green.
Green, and that's not the atmospheric colors we want.
Do I need more water?
So now I can come in and I can get my brush wet and use a paper towel and lift. Lift, lift, wherever I need it. If I got paint in an area I don't want, it's out of there.
Water?
Yeah, just around the corner to the right. There's a fresh one right here. You could just use this one.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the kitchen is just to the right.
Okay.
I can even grab paint with my paper. So what I want to share with you is we can get backruns on our paintings when one section is wetter than another and goes into a dry area. And because I'm painting this up and down like this, it's a little more challenging. And I'm getting backruns right in here, which is rather unfortunate because it's a line right against the edge. So I'm going to have to see if I can scrub that out a little bit. And I will maybe get some more foliage in here because I don't want a line against the edge. That's a parallel line and it's kind of a no-no. It's a continuous line across the bottom and that will make my viewer look off my painting. So thanks to my magic eraser, this is Mr. Clean Sponge. You can get it at the grocery store. It's cut into parts. You soak it, and then you can scrub right on the paper, and then you grab a paper towel and you dab, and I was able to remove that terrible parallel line that was happening. There's a little bit more in there, and I can scrub that too. The crazy thing is that you can't scrub your paper with a paper towel. If you scrub your paper with a paper towel, you actually lift up some of the filaments, and you get this funny little fuzz on there like you've bought a bad sweater and you have little pieces on there. So what you want is to always dab. Rub with your magic eraser, with a clean magic eraser, and then dab. Don't rub with paper.
Hang on.
So we're ready to go now. I've got my atmospheric base coat down. Now I have my colors ready to go. You should always have your tray ready. Then you're not fiddling around with trying to mix colors. And I'm using a green. What I typically do is I really like to use this light pale green. You can mix it if you don't have it. So the base green that I typically use is called Hooker's Green. Hooker's Green can be mixed with the yellow that you already have, and you can create that green.
And if you don't have Hooker's Green?
Oh, my goodness, what
will you do? I have to go buy one.
You do need to buy Hooker's Green, Jane.
Yes.
What green do you have?
I have the sap green. That's really pretty.
Yeah, the sap green is probably good too.
I have
sap
and apple.
That works. Sap green.
Would I mix that with yellow?
You can make a purple with the red and the blue. I already have a purple already pre-made, so I'm just going to use that purple. So again, you're working light to dark, and I'm looking at my image and I'm assessing it again, and I'm looking at what I've already drawn out. I already know that I want to intensify in back in here. We're going light to dark. So I know that I want bright little leaves in here. So I'll have a nice clean brush. Get the biggest brush you can. And I run it into my water, I put it against the edge, and then I use my paper towel. Some artists use a cloth towel. And then I'm gonna get this light color, the very lightest. You see how quickly I'm moving with this very large brush? This is the light source, this is the lightest color of green in here. So I have this light color of green, weaving that in. Like that. And I've got some more light down here. I've got that green down in here. I'm going right over the trunks of those trees because those are dark. And because they're dark, I don't have to worry about that. I can just go right over those. I'm just creating shape and pattern. I'm not getting caught in all those little leaves. I'm just going, okay, where are they? Where's the light? Where's the light? Let's get those babies in. Then I'm beefing it up a little bit more. I've got that mixed green. It's a little darker back in here. I'll keep working around. More green. Green's down in here. And what's happening up here? Well, it's really dark up here, but I'm going to go ahead and just pop some of those in. I'll get darker, darker as we go. And I've got some greens down in here. Just kind of create some shapes and some texture. Let's see, do I have any green down here? Well, there's just a tiny bit of reflected green. Always be thinking about that. This water is reflecting. Always make your water, anything you paint in the water that's reflecting should always be horizontal. So your line should always be horizontal. I'm going to put that green in to match the green above. Horizontal lines. So there's my first go at my greens. Now I happen to see some purpley colors in here. Cleaning my brush again. Some purpley colors down in here. And down towards the bottom, it's really a lot darker. I can keep intensifying the deep darkness as I go along, but I'm paying attention to my value sketch that I've made. I don't know if you can see my value sketch here. Here's my value sketch. I also know that it's pretty dark down here. See, I'm not all caught up in every little rock. I'm not worried about that. I'm only thinking about the shapes. What shape do we have here? Patterns and things going on over here. I haven't switched my brush at all. I still have this big heavy-duty brush. That forces me not to get all caught up in little details. So your brain can look at this and say, it's
nice to meet
these
you.
Are bushes. This is grass. But did I go and go, oh, here's a leaf, here's a leaf? No, I just did it real quickly. I hope that helps.